Elon Musk says his Mars rocket will be ready to fly next year, and he's not interested in people saying he's too optimistic. He says the short flight should be possible in the first half of next year, and this is what the rocket looks like. Look at the size and the scale of this. You've got the engines, the propellant tanks, the payloads. Samuel Burke joins me from London. So, I'm not sure. This rocket is going to fly next year to Mars. He thinks he's going to get it on its way by Mars, with or without anybody.
So he says he knows that his timelines are very optimistic, something that he's been criticized for in the past, Richard. We don't know if any humans will actually be on board, but what his end goal here is to get humans up there because of all the problems that he says we have on Earth. Part of his timeline in mentioning all of this, Richard, was discussing all the issues that he'd like to get people away from. So if we just put them up, he talked about carbon dioxide being a huge problem here on Earth. Another dark age, nuclear war, World War III, it's only Monday, Richard, and artificial intelligence. So these are all the things that he say could create so many problems and so many government regulations. A good show to talk about this on. He says it's hard for business because of all the government regulations. That's why he's thinking about going up there, because of all those issues here.
Right, but as I read earlier in the week, last week, in his speech in South by Southwest, he also made clear that his space endeavors and Tesla both nearly went bankrupt earlier on because, he said, they nearly ran out of money. Now they are much better off. But both, he nearly had to choose between one or the other.
And yet he runs so many companies, and this is one of the reasons that people, when they look at this 2019 timeline, not the second half of 2019, the first half of 2019, they're nearly perplexed. If I just go through the companies that he's running, SpaceX and Tesla are just a few of them. SpaceX, we all know, Tesla used to have Solar City as a separate company. Now they're one company. The Boring Company, Neuralink, and OpenAI. He's got a lot on his plate, though he gets the job done. But you always say you hope that people are profitable. A lot of the money that they have are people investing in the stock, Richard, hoping that one day these companies will be profitable. But for right now, the revenue just doesn't meet those expectations just yet.